So once we get ourselves familiar with all the different concentration units, our next task is to be able to convert between the concentration units. Because sometimes a measurement was made and we know the molarity, but in order to do a problem, we need the molality. So we have to be able to convert between those concentration units. So this lesson is about how to do that. It's really about paying very close attention to your units and doing a lot of unit conversions. But there's kind of a process that I would recommend you do. Now, I would highly recommend you do this. Sometimes it'll work in your own little way, and then you'll get stuck. If you use this method, it will work every time. Okay, so what do we do? What you're going to want to do in order to convert between concentration units is take that concentration unit and start by separating it into a numerator and a denominator. Let me give you some examples, okay? Let's say a solution is 3.5% by mass of sodium chloride, okay? I want to separate that into a numerator and a denominator. Well, the numerator is 3.5, and since it's percent, it's per 100, per 100. Put units with it. It's percent by mass. Put what it is. Sodium chloride in the numerator and solution in the denominator. So you take that and you divide it into a numerator and a denominator. Let's say we have a solution that says it's 2.5 capital M CH3OH. Okay, and we want to write that as a numerator and a denominator. Well, molarity is what a capital M is, and so it's 2.5 moles of the solute, okay, per liter of solution. How many liters? 1 liter. So that's what molarity means, the moles in a liter of solution. Let's say we have, that's good examples, okay? We'll do some more as we work through it. So you're going to separate the numerator and the denominator, and then you're going to really separate it. Just work with the numerator and just work with the denominator to convert over to the new units you're looking for in the concentration your unit you're trying to obtain. So you're going to work numerator, where does it need to go? Denominator, where does it need to go? And then put them back together again. Okay, you're going to recombine that numerator and denominator and divide them into each other to get a single number, single value for your new concentration unit. Now the last one is not part of the step-by-step, but something you just need to be aware of is some denominators are in mass, some denominators are in volume. To convert between mass and volume, you're going to need density. Can't do it without it. So sometimes you'll need to be given density in order to work the problem. Where students fall short is not being real specific. They'll just put moles and liters and not what it is. If you get yourself in the habit of writing the number, the unit, and the substance, the number, the unit, and what it is, you will make yourself make way fewer mistakes. So let's see some examples. In this example, I'm wanting to know the molarity of a solution that's 26% by mass of phosphoric acid, all right? So I'm going to take the concentration unit they gave me and write it as a fraction. 26.0% means per 100. It's percent by mass, so I give it mass units. And then I will get even more specific, grams of what? Well, this is H3PO4 being dissolved, and this would be the whole, the part over the whole. So this is the solution. So that's what I'm starting with, and where am I trying to go? It's wanting molarity. So I tell myself, okay, what's molarity? It is moles of the solute, in this case, H3PO4, and the denominator is liter of solution. So I know where my numerator needs to go and where my denominator needs to go, and I'm going to work with them separately. In my numerator, okay, I have 26 grams of H3PO4. I don't want grams, I'm trying to get to moles. And I know quite well how to go from grams of H3PO4 to moles of H3PO4. If I go and look up the molar mass of phosphoric acid, it's 98 grams in a mole. And I am left now working my numerator to where I'm trying to get my numerator, and I have 0.265 moles of H3PO4. Notice a number, a unit, and a substance. Okay, now I'm ready to work with my denominator. I have 100 grams of solution. Not just 100 grams, 100 grams of solution. I don't want grams of solution. I'm trying to get to liters of solution. This is a mass. I'm trying to get to a volume. So let's see. They gave me the density, and it's in grams per milliliter. So I can say I don't want grams of this solution. They gave me the density, so I know the milliliters of the solution. That's not the density of the water that it's dissolved in. It is the density of the solution. It says that the solution has a density of 1.155 grams in a milliliter. Now I have milliliters of solution, but what I really need is liters of solution. Milli means 10 to the minus 3. And when I multiply and divide, as I see here, I have 0.0866 liters. Now I'm ready. I've worked my numerator. I've worked my denominator. I'm ready to recombine them to get the molarity. So it's, there's a zero there, 0.265 moles of phosphoric acid per, the denominator is 0.0866 liters of solution, and the value for that will be 3.06, and we could write it as moles per liter or put a big M there, and that is molarity, okay? The molarity is 3.06 moles per liter. All right, so separate them, work the numerator and denominator separately, and put them back together again. Let's do the next one. Molarity. What did I just do? Molarity. Oh, that's the answer. Okay, nothing happened. Okay, so now we're ready to do molality. So I'm going to change colors so we can keep straight this one. It looks a little similar, but it's got a couple letters different, and we're going to get molality instead. So if I'm working this problem here, I again take, I'm going to pretend like I haven't done all this up here. I have my 26.0 grams of H3PO4, and that is per 100 grams of solution because they told me it was 26%. I think about where I'm trying to go. I'm trying to go to molality. So that is moles of H3PO4 per kilogram, and this is of water, the solvent. It is not the solution, so we have to be really, really careful with that. So, numerator. The numerator, we're going to take the 26 grams of H3PO4 and convert it to moles. Now, I did do that already up here, okay? So I'm not going to waste your time by doing it again. If you do all of that work that you see right up here, you're going to have 0.265 moles of H3PO4. No sense doing that again. But if it was a fresh problem, we'd go and do this. All right, denominator. This is where students don't complete the process sometimes. We are doing two different conversions. Actually, here, what are we doing? We're going from mass, it's still mass, but it's grams and kilograms. But here's the biggie. Solution is everything. Water is just the solvent. So there has to be some subtraction in order to get just to the solvent. So if I have 100 grams of solution, and I subtract out the grams of the solute, which is the H3PO4, I would be left with the grams of water. Does that make sense? That's the grams of water. So this isn't dimensional analysis, is it? This is subtraction. But I will go ahead and go from grams of water to kilograms of water because the denominator has to be in kilograms. And kilo means 1,000, so I have 0.074 kilograms of water. Then I'm ready to plug those values in. I worked my numerator. I have 0.265 moles of phosphoric acid. I have my denominator, 0.074 kilograms of water. And when I divide those two values, I get 3.59. We could write moles per kilogram, or we can put a little m. It's a 3.59 molal solution. So, starting with the same percent, the molarity and the molality are not the same. They might be the same. If the solution is really, really dilute, then you're subtracting out such a small number that the kilograms of the water are about the same as the liters of the solution. So, gets dilute, they start getting really close. The more concentrated it is, the further apart those two values will be. Okay, so it's very important that you can go between any of those concentration units. We could give you any one and ask you to determine any other one. And so you're going to want to practice that, not with a bunch of memorized steps, because there's way too many things we could throw at you. These are all just conversions that you know how to do, and you can think your way through them if you'll be really careful and write those units out every step of the way.